All right, in this lesson, we're going to use y equals mx plus b, the slope-intercept form, to actually help us graph a line. Now, let me remind you of a few things. The first way that you learned to graph a line was using a t-chart, or just some ordered pairs. You might have had something like, let's suppose I have y equals 2x plus 1. You might have had 0, and if that would have a y value of 1, you have 1, that would have a y value of 3. You would plot 2 points, and I'm sorry, I'm just going to make this super hand-drawn, 0, 1, and 1, 3, and you would have a line. Okay, that was one way. The second way we learned was with intercepts. And with intercepts, I still encourage people to draw a chart, but I tell them you must use the zeros. If x is 0, then y would be 1. If y is 0, x will be negative 1/2. Okay, I kind of picked a one that's not so friendly. And you wouldn't be asked to graph it this way, but I'm just going to show you. All right, 0, 1 is the y-intercept. Negative 1/2, 0, is the x-intercept. And you would have that. And if you can see that it's the same line. All right, we're going to learn now in this lesson a third way to graph lines, and it is called slope intercept, and it uses both of those. So I'm going to do an example, and I am sorry, I'm not going to have a grid. So I'm, once again, it's going to be a hand-drawn graph. I have y equals, let's look at that 2x plus 1. Well, from what we've seen in previous lessons, that's y equals mx plus b. B is the y-intercept. So it is the point 0, 1 on the y-axis. M is the slope, and it is 2. Now, I like my slope when I'm going to use it to show me vertical change over horizontal change. That means that I always like my slope when I'm going to use it to be a fraction. If there is no denominator, put a 1. Remind yourself that slope is vertical over horizontal. A positive 2 means I will go up 2. Horizontal positive 1 means I will go right 1. Here's something that might be helpful. Let B tell you where to begin on the y-axis. Let M tell you how to move to another point. B for begin on the y-axis, M for move. All right, so if I were going to graph this line using that information, once again, hand-drawn graph. I don't recommend these, but I hope it will be effective for just teaching. Begin at 1 on the y-axis. So put a point literally at 1 on the y-axis. M is for move. From that point, start at that point and use these as your moving instructions. Your moving instructions say go up 2 blocks, 1, 2, and go right 1 block. There we go. And draw the line. It's the same line, and you did not have to do any chart to get these points. You begin at the y-intercept, and you move to another point according to your slope instructions. So now let's do several problems, and I will talk a little bit about how you will do it in MATLAB. All right, the first one. Use a slope-intercept form to graph this equation. All right, I have, let me go to black ink. I have y equals 7x minus 4. Remember, this is y equals mx plus b. Begin at negative 4 on the y-axis. Now, it's very, very important that you remember that's on the y-axis. M stands for move. It's the number 7. Doesn't have a denominator, so let me give it a 1. Those are both positive. So the numerator is vertically up 1. I'm sorry, up 7. The denominator horizontally right 7. Let's use that information. I would go to MATLAB. I would click on the line graph tool. And when I hover over the graph, I will have crosshairs. I need to have my first point at negative 4 on the y-axis, so I will click my mouse right there. Whoops. From there, from that exact point, I will move up 7 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I will move right 1 block, and it's a little bit tough when I hold it like that, it begins to want to open something. So, but there's my second point. It was up 7, right 1. In MATLAB, a line would be drawn for you. And I have drawn my own little crooked line. You won't have to worry about actually drawing it. All right, let's look at another one. Y equals negative 8 fifths x minus 1. I will begin at negative 1 on the y-axis. Now, be careful with this slope. There's a negative sign. It's directly in front of the fraction. It's up to you. You can put it with the top and let the bottom be positive, or you can drop it down and put it with the denominator. It is totally up to you. All right, so let me show you how they'll both work. Line graph tool. Begin at negative 1 on the y-axis. There's my first point. Now, from those, if I use this set of instructions, moving instructions, it will tell me to go down 8, because that's the vertical change, and right 5. Let's see where that will leave me. Down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and from there, right 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now, if instead I use this version, that would tell me to go up 8. That would tell me to go left 5 from where I was supposed to begin. So if I am right here, if I went up 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and left 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whoops. Well, that really messed up. Okay. It doesn't like, it thinks I'm trying to open something when I do that. But I think you can see that whichever way you went, you would end up with points that were on the same line. Even though I cannot seem to draw a straight line. Okay, it's supposed to go through those points. You'll only plot two points, so you won't do both of these. You'll pick the one. If you pick one set, you'll get this as your second point. If you do the other way, you'll get this as your second point. Either way, though, you've got the same line. All right, next one, y equals 6x. If I'm trying to compare that to y equals mx plus b, I can tell that my m is 6, or 6 over 1, but my b, there's nothing there. Numerically, that would mean that b is 0 on the y-axis. Well, 0 on the y-axis is right here. and my moving instructions, up six, right one. So up six, right one. There's my point, and I would get this line. Right? Sometimes the equation of the line does not start out in slope-intercept form. This one doesn't. I will need to subtract 6x from both sides to get y equals negative 6x minus 1. The b value is negative 1. That's where I'll begin, on the y-axis. How will I move? Well, the number in the place of m is negative 6. Put it over 1. That tells me it is down 6, right 1. Okay, so draw my line. Begin at negative 1. That's my first point. From there, go down 6, go right 1, and there's my second point. And that will be something like the line that you will get. Let's look at a little bit more, just one more. Suppose I have 5x minus 3y is equal to 15. If I'm going to use slope-intercept, then I need to get y by itself. So subtract 5x, negative 3y is equal to negative 5x plus 15. Divide everything by negative 3, and y is equal to negative over negative is positive. 5 thirds x, positive divided by negative, is negative 5. Begin at negative 5 on the y axis, and your slope is 5 over 3, which is up 5, right 3. Remember that slope is always vertical over horizontal. So I will begin at negative 5 on the y-axis. From there, I'll go up 5 and right 3, and I just happen to land on the other axis. That's just a particular to this. And I've got my line because I only need 2 points. All right, that slope-intercept y equals mx plus b is going to be one of your best friends in graphing lines.